Hey everybody, it's Glenn with the Cactus Atlas coming at you from the Coconino National Forest near Sedona in search of the crack at Wet Beaver Creek. Okay, so what exactly am I doing again? I'm looking for the crack at Wet Beaver Creek. Wet Beaver Creek, I believe, is running down that way where you see all those trees. It's a creek that I think flows year-round, and the crack is a geological feature. Maybe about 3.5 miles the way we're walking, where it's a popular swimming hole and a popular place for cliff diving and other nice, cool activities. I started the adventure this morning early. It's a Sunday morning. It's probably, let's see, I can tell you exactly. It's about 7:45 in the morning. The parking lot was pretty empty. It's late April, approaching summer. I think this is a very popular destination in the summer when it's hot. A little chilly in the morning here. It's starting to warm up quickly, so I'm curious if we're gonna see a lot of folks swimming today. And I think this is affirmation that I'm going the correct way. The crack. All right. I know some of you are giggling out there, the crack at Wet Beaver Creek. I get it. Amy told me to be factual and to the point today. So no jokes coming from me. But I recognize what some of you are thinking out there. You with sick minds, like me. I've also read that this trail is pretty clear and easy, like you see so far, free of a lot of obstructions, and pretty flat. I think only a couple hundred feet of elevation gain overall. I've read that it starts to turn into more like red rock country, like Sedona, and that people say that it feels like you're in Sedona at parts. I'm starting to see why. Oh, nice. I could see trails now kind of going off down into the shade, and I see my first glimpse of the creek. Looks like a crystal clear stream from up here. You can see it's very clear water, very clean and refreshing like. Ah, this is the life down here. This spot is a beautiful overlook, actually. I'm assuming we're heading towards the center of the screen, either that way or slightly to the left of this. Time will tell. You can kind of see the trail hugging the side of the cliffs off to the left. Based on just beauty alone, this hike is worth it just for this scenery, in my opinion. This is fantastic. These are some really nice views of these red rocks, these cliffs that have just appeared virtually out of nowhere. And now I feel like I'm in Sedona, full on now. And way down there you can see the creek, Wet Beaver Creek. But we still have yet to find the crack. mean, everybody else is like hustling for the grand finale, but I'm just awestruck by this beautiful landscape to get there. And by the way, the place is dog friendly. I think they have to be on a leash, but I've read that. So I think you're free to bring your pets and your kids too. And the cliffs are now starting to loom and close in on us as we descend. You really start to feel their majesty and being in their presence. So the recommended time of year to visit here is April through October, I guess the warmer season. But I would think this would still be a fantastic hike in the winter time. I don't see why not. I guess they just say that mainly because of the swimming opportunities that abound down here. We'll be the judge of that. Although I've done some recon and some investigative work in advance, and I can tell you, my expectations are pretty high. I think this is gonna be pretty cool. Very cool if you're talking about the water temperature. One other thing that I think has just become essential is my get up here. Maybe some of you think it's a shtick. This schmog in my hat, not trying to bust out any adventure-y vibes or Indiana Jones vibes. It's really practical. Really, the older I get, the more I worry about my skin cancer and stuff like that, since there's a lot of sun. So really trying to protect my ears and my neck. I always get sunburn on my neck. So this thing has become essential. Oh yeah, check it out. I think we found it. I think it's this whole general area. You could see some people have grabbed places to put all their towels and stuff. So let's get down there and take a look. All right. It is kind of an oasis, but by the sounds of those fellas that jumped in there, it's freezing. It's a little cooler back here too. The wind's blowing, a lot of shade, and a lot of nice looking pools to swim in. We'll try to make our way over that way before we kind of come and re-explore the cliffs over here. Hey, somebody was here to welcome me in this wall of graffiti. It's unfortunate, but what do you expect with a bunch of drunk college kids hanging out here? No Sinawan petroglyphs, it looks like. Yeah, you can continue down trying to find a place that nobody's hanging out at to call my own. That babbling brook down below has my name written on it. Always willing to perform for the YouTuber. So those guys, if you're watching us, like especially you who did the backflip, right on, fella. That was actually pretty sweet. More guts than I got, at least in my old age. I used to do that. Okay, looks like if I want to find a way through here, this is probably my best bet, is to head on up this. So a lizard just kind of sunning itself. I interrupted its sunning. Very tranquil over here, away from where all the people are. Most of the people seem to be hanging out by the cliffs where you can dive in. it's a little bit harder to navigate back here than I thought. Because you either have like the tall cliffs at the crack proper, or you gotta really finagle your way through these areas like I'm doing. Hopefully it's worth it. This area back here is beautiful and all mine so far. I just kind of brute forced it through the water and got my left foot completely submerged. Water's not as cold. It's cool, don't get me wrong, but it's not as cold as I thought it would be. I thought it would be a shockingly cold experience, but I'm sure if I jumped in from being dry, it would be freezing, but not bad. You could see some deeper areas. I don't think this is deep enough over here to cliff dive. I could easily see the bottom. That's probably like 4 or 5 feet deep, I'm gonna guess, right there. I could be wrong, but you could see these cliffs up here. Probably be tempting to jump off of, but I think that would be a little dangerous. I mean, if you come back here, you're best off preparing to get a little wet. It's really what the place is for, is to cool off. I've just been hanging out down here. It's so cool. I got my feet completely wet, got water in my boots. It doesn't really flow out. So I'm gonna have to empty my boots out when I get a chance up there before I hike back, but it's so worth it. Waiting out here a little bit. The rocks are really slippery though in there, so they're really slimy. So for me it's difficult because I want to film and walk around with my cameras, but really watch your step though if you go in there. Almost took a tumble a couple times. So my boots are not really meant for full-on submersion. They are waterproof. They're Salomons. Some of you ask about my boots from time to time, so Amy's putting links in the description down below to all the stuff that I use. But you could see, if you wear sneakers, you know, come prepared to walk in at least shallow water like this. And if you're crafty, you could probably get by without getting your feet wet, but I'm starting to wonder, why would you care? Let's take one last look at our little quiet oasis that we found here at the crack at Wet Beaver Creek. Wet Beaver Creek is awesome. I had no idea it was this good. So yes, it's already exceeding my expectations if you're wondering. I always reveal my feelings prematurely, don't I? But I've seen enough to make that judgment. You know, that exposed, hot, sunny hike to get here is almost a requirement, because if you once you do that, you get down here into the shade, the cool breezes blowing off the water, the coolness of the water itself, it's fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. Time to cross back over these spider-covered, bee-covered boulders. Lots of bees back here, but they're not bothering people. Occasional butterflies and moths. But lots of weird brown spiders. They're really afraid of people. They scurry. But if you don't like spiders, you're not gonna like it back where I just was. So that's just proof once again that if you're persistent and you try to seek seclusion, it's not too far from reach. Everybody seems to be hanging out where those gentlemen were doing those backflips today. Thank you. got out from down below. Get one last look of this crack. It's paradise back here. We found the crack at Wet Beaver Creek, and it exceeded expectations for sure. I was able to squeeze out all the water out of my socks the best I could. And there was water inside the shoe that wasn't flowing out, so now I feel better, but I have some very wet feet and about 3.5 miles to hike back in a much hotter time of the day. Anyway, I love this place, and yes, as the day's gone on, it's about noon now. Lots of younger college age folks, I would say, having a good time, but everybody's been really cool today. So chatted with a couple folks. One guy asked me, hey, did you jump? I'm like, are you crazy? Maybe 20 years ago I would have. I assume the crack proper is the area where everybody was jumping off the cliffs, and that section's kind of small. Really neat, but like I said, upstream it was a little bit more quiet, like little pools you could swim in. Not sure what's upstream even further. Just didn't have time to go further and didn't dress appropriately, so maybe next time. All right, let's review some quick stats. According to All Trails, I went 8.7 miles today and about 5 hours and 25 minutes total. About 4 hours and 20 minutes was moving time, so apparently I spent about an hour not moving. Keep in mind, I take a lot of pictures, video, blah, blah, blah. You've heard it all before, and that's what really accounts for the timing. But yeah, when you get over there, there's really no reason to rush. You should, if you're gonna hike all the way out there, you gotta stop and enjoy it. All right, folks, so there you have it, the hike out to the crack at Wet Beaver Creek. What a fantastic hike that was, especially for the cool surprise at the end. Despite the name, this place is amazing. And the name's kind of interesting too.